Oh, this is bad, and he's deleted off the scene. What up, guys? It's your boy RapTRz here, bringing you my first ever Paragon video. I'm excited. I'm hyped. I got my microphone. I got that Blue Yeti. I got my Elgato. You know, you got a job, you got to spoil a little bit. So, you know, I was like, you know, I'm finally gonna get my stuff back. Start YouTube again. You know, I used to do YouTube back in high school. Right now, I'm a college student, part-time, you know, working and whatnot. Blah blah blah. Who cares? Today we're playing some Paragon. And this is not live commentary. This is pre-recorded. I didn't have my mic set up when I first started playing, but you know, I still playing anyways, and I was still recording the live gameplay, but I just didn't record any commentary over it. But I was just like, you know, this gameplay was really good, so I just really wanted to share it with you guys, you know, talk you up around it, you know, probably review, analyze some of the mistakes and plays that I got. And I'm running Portal Stone on this build. It's just damage. You got some armor, you got some Toon Barrier in there, you know, because you want to build tanky as Iggy. Like, I cannot stress it enough, you already know, if you're a Paragon player, you already know you got to build armor on almost everybody, and I'm talking almost everybody. When I first started playing Paragon, you know, I went straight damage, and I learned that pretty fast that that's not the way to go. You know, glass cannon builds are fine for carries, whatnot, but you know, the last thing you want to do is get melted and not even last in team finds, but whatever. You know, this game was a really good game. The laning phase in the beginning, it drags on a little bit, man. But, you know, I was rolling with your boy Iggy and Scorch, so in the beginning here, I do lane against another Iggy, and we have our little battles here, just laning. You already know. Like, this thing, it drags on a little bit longer than it should have, but during the late mid game, things get really interesting. Most of you don't know me, this is my first Paragon video. Before I started even doing Paragon, you could check my old stuff out. It was a lot of Call of Duty stuff. I had a clan and whatnot. It was really cool. It was a fun time, you know, in high school. And you know, Call of Duty is fine. It was fun. You know, for me, you know, I started Call of Duty when I was like Modern Warfare 2, and then, you know, after Black Ops 1, it was alright. Black Ops 2 was good, Black Ops 3, eh. After that, I was like, nah. And I got into Paragon. I got into Paragon, like, I think when the beta first started, around, I want to say September. Yeah, I think it was in September or August that the beta started. But I know it was in the beginning of the beta, and I play console, by the way. I play on PS4. I do plan on getting a better PC, maybe play on PC, but as far as getting a PC, getting a good PC costs a lot of money. You know, I'm right here, I'm just laning against Iggy. You're gonna see me not really using my abilities that much, cause you really, the last thing you want to do when you're playing as Iggy or as a caster, just in general, you don't want to run out of mana and have your enemy full of mana, and then you having to retreat, or maybe a jungler rotates over and you know your lane's gonna take some damage, or if not, your lane's gonna die as far as your tower. So I really do avoid trying to use my my abilities. You know, I try to make sure that the tower does some damage on the minions. Still trying to get those last hits. My farming was all right in the beginning. It picks up a little bit though, better, and it picks up a lot better in the late game when I do pick up some kills. And like I said, I was running Portal Stone on this build. Which is really, it's a really underrated card. It recently got updated to where it's only 5 points now, which is a lot better. It used to be 7 points, and I still had it, but it was like a really big investment to do 7 points. But now it's 5 points, and it's really good. I think the only person that I can really use it on, because the only person I do use it on is Iggy. And, you know, in this current update, your towers are really important. especially your tier 2 towers, that was the reasoning behind why I put Portal Stone. Because in general, Iggy is the lane pusher. He's the guy to go to when you're pushing lanes. And I think he's one of the best, if not the best, lane pusher in the game. So I really wanted to capitalize on that and have Portal Stone to be able to rotate when you feel it's too late. Because believe me, I know there's been a lot of cycles between the game where they took out... They slowed down travel mode, which is popular or not, it is what it is. And that's why I put Portal Stone, because I really wanted to, be able to rotate between towers. So in the beginning, I have to pick up my ward, to be safe, because I had a lot of games where I was laning and I did not have wards when I was trying out different builds, whether it was more with Murdoch, with Iggy, or whatnot. I usually carry with Murdoch or Sparrow. I recently started getting to Sparrow. Sparrow's really good. Also Murdoch's really good. Murdoch is just... I don't know. I don't know what it is. I just sometimes do not do good with Murdoch. And then at some games I do really good with Murdoch, or some days I do really bad. Like, it's one or the other. So I just have had really good experiences with Murdoch. So I tried Sparrow. Sparrow's really good. I don't know what it is, but I just do a lot better. Anyways, getting off topic here, the Iggy in this game really put a lot of pressure on me. Like, he or she was just like spamming those turrets, and I was trying not to use my mana, because I wanted him to use all his mana, and then I could push and really, get up in his face. I do place one turret though, because I don't want the tower taking too much damage. But what was I saying? My main guy to go to in Paragon, I'm a jungler. I love jungling. I really like ganking. I love rotating. I love everything. I like being in the middle of the fights. And that's just the role I really like playing. And my jungler is Grux. I'm a master Grux. I tried so many builds with Grux, and I just finally found the right build that I really do like. And I roll with it now. It's a little bit of everything. If anything, it's not like a lot of damage. If anything, it's what you would call a bruiser, where you can shred armor and you can still do pretty good, true damage with penetration. And it, I found that to work the best. Like, I've tried Life Leech, and I've tried Crit. I tried a lot of different things. I've tried really tanky Grux, and it's not as good as you would think it is, but. My Grux build is still pretty tanky. Like, it has health and armor, so. But it also has a lot of damage and penetration and shredding armor, so, which is really good. But anyways, I really recently started playing Iggy a lot more. Right now, I build him with armor, like I said, and then I also build him with the Portal Stone and a lot of damage. And then right here, I do pick up the little pressure, and I see my teammates in the jungle. I think about going to the jungle to help them out, but this Iggy doesn't rotate, so I hold back on that and just keep putting pressure. And I see that Iggy might go, and he just disappears for like the longest time, and I don't know where he goes, but everybody in the jungle seems to get away, so I just continue to keep pushing. This was a really fun game, by the way. I wish I recorded the live commentary, because it was really fun. But, I talk way too much right now. Anyways, our team does really good as far as, keeping their lanes. Because recently, man, I had a lot of games where, I'm not to be salty, but, straight up, people don't know how to play their role, and it's... Whether they're new players or not, it's just at the end of the game, you lose because they didn't play the role. But we all learn, and we all get a lot better. But when you do have good games, we do have a lot of good games when I play. But recently, I've been having a lot of bad games because of that. I do solo queue. I had a friend who used to play Paragon with me, back when the beta started, but he doesn't play with me no more. Well, he's gonna start playing. We might do some dual commentary, maybe in the future. But Anyways, should talk about more of the gameplay than anything. It feels weird, man. It feels weird being back on YouTube. It was a good hobby of mine, man. I used to do a lot of YouTube. I used to edit a lot. Like, if you look back at my older videos, it's Call of Duty, it's not Paragon, but I did a lot of editing, and I would do all that. I would capture it all, I would edit it all, I would learn how to do it all, like, on YouTube, you know. Maybe if an editor's watching this, you can relate, like, just the hours spent into, like, learning how to do things. It's really time-consuming. I remember a lot of the stuff, so hopefully in the future, I'm gonna do like more like little montages or maybe like cinematic kind of things with Paragon, and that's something I've been really visioning a lot, which I would really want to do. And then I've been thinking about doing live commentaries, obviously, you know, maybe it's like analysis videos like what I'm doing right now, but this is more like a, for me, this is more like a refresher, trying to get used to this again, because it's really been a long time since, I know, I've talked in my room to like a microphone. Like, you don't do that every day. So I'm just getting really used to that again, and hopefully you guys enjoy the video. And I noticed left side have a lot of trouble on this part, but I can't rotate over, because I know if I leave my lane, Iggy's just gonna push this down my throat. So, you know, at this point, you really gotta know when to rotate. Because I could have rotated over to the left side and maybe saved that tower. Or maybe I would have not been able to rotate and I would have lost that tower and I would lose mid tower. So, sometimes, man, you just, it sucks, but you have to let towers go. Obviously, there's a fine line between that. And I see that Iggy backs off right now, so I use my ultimate to try to like force push this, but then Grux comes over and he almost kills me, and I start to panic when he pulls me, but I stay in my turret just to make sure he takes a lot of damage, because I know I hit pretty hard in the beginning of the match with the turrets, especially with a melee fighter, because they really have to get in your face to knock down those turrets. The mistake that I could have done when Grux did pull me in was just to run away, because I would have probably died. So, you know, the best choice that I had right there was to do a lot of damage and try to stay into my turrets. And luckily our Kai and our I think we have a Grux in this game. I think we have two junglers. I'm not sure who the other jungler was, but our junglers do really good in this game, which is really good to see, because I've played a lot of games where like junglers they don't gank, and that could be a problem sometimes if you don't have a good jungler. And I just right here, I just pick up more damage. But you know, junglers are really important, especially when you're laning, because if you don't have a good jungler, and if you don't have somebody who could gank or like, you know, make a difference in the game, then the laning phase takes forever, which this game it kind of dragged on. And I noticed that the Rampage and Iggy do are about to get this tower, and I think they're gonna get it, but I managed to get there in time and like bust his ass with my ultimate, and luckily it actually even kills him. And luckily Kai came in here too and helped me out with the tower. I thought when Kai killed the other guy that I was killing, I thought he was gonna protect my lane, but apparently not. But they do even manage to get Iggy as well, which is really good, because I do manage to get the mid tower on this part right here, which is really good, really, really good. Luckily, they didn't get the mid tower, you know. But yeah, you know, the best thing to do in situations when they do get your tower is the least you can do to trade off is at least get a kill, or kill them. You know, when they kill you, because you want to have them down, so maybe you could push another tower, give you some free wiggle room. Because I see a lot of games where people they see their tower get destroyed, and they have the opportunity to collapse on them and get the kill, but a lot of the times that doesn't happen, and you know, they let them get away and with a free tower. So you don't want to do that. You want to really capitalize on an enemy when they do get a tower. And if you have, obviously there's a fine line, you know, you should never chase a kill into another tower or into the jungle. That's just, you know, that's you just never want to chase in general. Like, you don't want to chase unless, you know, you have the opportunity to and you think you get to kill and a lot of enemies are down and you feel like you cannot get collapsed on, then go ahead. You know, obviously taking note that you're, all your lanes are pushed. Like, it's really, really little room to have an exception to chase a kill, you know. And you can get punished for that really easily and really bad. Especially with the death timers, man. And, you know, Iggy comes back right here. He's really mad. Because I'm surprised I even killed Rampage. Because he didn't even have a lot of health or a lot of his ultimate. I just melted him with my ultimate. Which I was really surprised because I thought he was going to survive it. Like, most of the time, you know. Rampage just jumps away with his freaking huge leap of faith to, like, across the map. And then... Oh my god, I love this part, because the enemy Iggy gets really saucy with me, and he tries to kill me, but I come back in his face. It's so funny. You know, but I feel like the enemy team and our team did really good. It was a really fun game overall, but right here, I'm just trying to put constant pressure on mid lane, just to give my just keep the enemy Iggy occupied, and also just to give my other partners a lot more room, because my other partners, I noticed that they're doing really good in lane, which I was surprised, which was really good, because that means I didn't have to rotate as much as I did. Right here, I mess up by going down and not taking into consideration Iggy's air, but my damage just overall just melts them, like, completely. And I just managed to keep pushing the lane. And I pushed the lane pretty far up into their tier 2 to make force someone to rotate. And a lot of things I noticed too recently, I really use the comms a lot, which a lot of players don't do. They like, if you're gonna say you're gonna be right back, please tell tell your teammate, because I've been into situations when I think my teammate's with me and I realize he's not, and I just die. Like, I've had that situation, but using comms is really good. Here again with the Grux, I'm really reckless when it comes to not keeping my map awareness. And recently in this game, because I was getting a little saucy with it. Like, after melting that Iggy, I was like pretty powerful early game, and it was funny noting how the Grux didn't go after me, like, as far as trying to kill me, because, you know, I do pretty good damage. So it was funny seeing that. Usually it's the other way around. Usually when you see a jungler come up towards you, especially as a laner, you're like, oh shit, I'm dead. But in that case, he had pretty low health too, so he backed off. I almost killed him. I tried to kill him. But I think right here I pick up my portal stone for sure. Ooh, and I love this play right here. Portal Stone is really good as far as Iggy, because I noticed right here on the right, Sparrow is, like, really trying to push the lane, and she's about to get the lane, and I see nobody's really close except for Kai. But, you know, Kai, I think he's, like, he doesn't even go for it. So I just Portal Stone over to the Harvester, and Sparrow gets a really big present from Iggy right here. This is why I love Portal Stone, because of these moments right here when Sparrow has no idea that I'm right behind her. And she completely gets melted. It's oh my god, I love that. That's probably like my favorite part of the video. There's another part where I use Portal Stone to get another kill, but that was my favorite one, because it's funny, because a lot of people don't use Portal Stone, so they don't really expect that. And right here, we also get the Grux way off guard again. I try to put down my turret, make sure to get some damage. But our Kai, again, shout out to the Kai in the video. He was really good. He always ganked, like, at the right moments. It was so good. So, you know, I ultimately rotated over to right, just to save that tower. And we do end up losing our mid tower, but, you know, by that point, it was already kind of dead, so... As far as when I play Iggy, I usually, I'm always in lane, which you should be in lane. You don't want to be jungling or none of that, obviously. As Iggy, you just really, really want to be a pain in the ass. You want to be that guy, like, oh my god, Iggy's freaking pushing her lane again. Like, that's what you have to do as Iggy. Yeah, just put pressure, 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 pressure. That's all I do in this game, is put pressure on lanes. Obviously, it works really good because I force a lot of people to rotate over to lanes that, you know, usually don't need that much attention. Because they're, you know, for the most part of the game, their left lane is, like, pretty exposed for the most part, because I'm always, like, in the right lane. And I save right lane, like, a couple times. Later in the video, I portal stone again, and I save it again. Spoilers. But anyways, right here, we just, all my team all rotates over. Same with the enemy team. They rotate over as well. The enemy team really rotated pretty good in this game. To be honest, like, the Rampage and their Iggy was pretty good too, but at this point I'm level 13, my Richter is a level 8, so I've been really farming really good. Also getting the kills helped a lot, those early game kills, which I surprised myself with a lot too. Right here I see you know, Richter pull off his ultimate, so I try to use my ultimate, and we again, Kai taking the cake, you already know what it is, you know. So the Sparrow just, the ultimate really didn't help that much for her. We do ultimately, though, get the tower. Being saucy again, I use my ability to run to the tower, but, you know, it was a really fun game. Anyways. And, again, man, our Kai is a freaking monster, man. I felt like a dick playing Iggy, because we were doing so good, and we just constantly putting pressure on this. Right here, our Kai gets really into big trouble, so at first, I'm like trying to retreat, but then I go into body block him, because I see that Rampage like really wants that kill. But we get away anyways. Again, body block, and we managed to get away. So that was really good. Really good play on our part. Again, good job, good job. And Portal Stone, the only bad part about Portal Stone is that the cooldown time is like really long. It's like 300 seconds, and that's the only bad part. You can have Blink Shot, but you know, a lot of people use Blink Shot as far as like the carries, like Murdoch, Sparrow. I personally use Blink Shot a lot too, and it helps a lot. But for Iggy, I really liked putting Portal Stone instead, because you can also use Portal Stone to escape here when you're getting shout out to Cluck Cluck. I love you, Iggy. I die though right here, man. I think that's like my first death too. I think somebody rotates though over to save right. But anyways, we did really good. Yeah, but I was saying Portal Stone, you could use it, you know, ultimately you want to really be wary when you do use it, because of that long cooldown time. Like I said, it's 300 seconds. So you really want to use it when you feel like you could really save a tower. You don't want to use it too late, because then you might use it and you might still not get the tower. Or you can use it to escape too. You could use it just like a blink shot, but it's a lot more safer. Like if you know when to use it, because it's like you might have seen in the video, there's a little cooldown. Like it's like if you're recalling back, as you saw, like it takes a couple seconds to activate it, but you could use it as an escape as well, which I don't recommend using it as an escape. As Iggy, you have your escape, you have the oil trail, which gives you that that movement speed. But you can also use a portal stone to escape, but you ultimately want it to use it to defend lanes. Like you're gonna see me right now in a bit, use it again right here on right lane, because I do see their enemy Grux. Going to right lane, which is right here. Same again, same play, same thing with the portal stone. Again, saving right lane, man. Especially in this meta, man, you gotta protect your towers, man. You really gotta protect your towers. And there we go again, man, with the portal stone. And again, we catch Grux off guard. He doesn't even know I rotated over, because nobody uses portal stone. Like, nobody uses it. And we do manage to kill him here. Like, I thought he was going to escape, though, man. Because our Richter pulls him into the tower. You know, that's a good thing that Richter did that. But he didn't see me use my ultimate, which is all good. It's all good, you know. And Grux almost gets away. So I see, because I know I've played Grux. And I know what he's thinking. He wants to dash out right when we get a chance. So I try to zone off with the turrets before he gets away. I put a turret back, he dashes, but... That's a bad day. That's a bad day. Alright, those Richters, man. They'll pull you back into oblivion. Like, once he pulls you, you're a dead man. And we lose right tower, man. We got too thirsty for that kill, but it's all good, man. At this point in the game, you know that you're doing better than the enemy team. Let alone knowing that they can make a comeback still, but at this part, we're doing really good in this game. Another good play right here up on the up and coming, man. There's so many good plays in this video, man. There's so many good plays, especially that Sparrow one in the beginning. That was a really good play. I love that kill, that Sparrow kill, and then the Grux kill that we had right here. And something a little funny happens right here, man. Because Murdoch rotates over to help her Sparrow, but I wouldn't want to be that Murdoch, man. Especially with the damage I'm carrying right now. Oh, this is bad, and he's deleted off the scene. And it's funny because casters, they usually don't get that many kills. I think I get like six or four kills in this game. I get six kills in here. I was debating on going keep putting pressure on right, but I see that they're trying to take their middle tower, so I try to push this up with them. Just to help them out, because I see the enemy team, the rest of them rotated over here to mid tower. I could have went to left lane, but I saw Kai was going all the way over there already, so we almost get in a little hassle here, but I think everybody escapes as far as here as it goes. No, yeah, Richter dies. Oh, I think I died too. I forgot I died here. We fucked up, man. Got a little too aggressive. The best choice was probably to back off, because all four of them were up, and I knew Sparrow was gonna rotate, and I knew she was gonna cause a problem. But you know, just being reckless, man, can cost you life. Luckily, on the left side, Kamir was pushing left lane, but. Yeah, so anyways, we come back, and at this point, we lost a tier 2 tower, so really, I try to move into mid lane. I see that Grux is in trouble. At this point, I'm like, yo, he's dead. Like, there's no way I'm gonna get there in time, especially with the travel mode speed. But recently, I really love playing Iggy, though my main guy is Grux all the time. I'll do gameplay, of course, in the future with Grux. I play Grux a lot. I play Iggy a lot, and Sparrow as far as carries, and Murdoch. And also I also play Muriel for support too a lot. Obviously, I'm gonna do a lot more builds and a lot of different characters that I usually don't play, or I usually really haven't experimented with. Obviously, I'm gonna do that because I, you know, for myself too, I also want to, you know, experiment and get to really feel the other characters. Because recently, the only people I've been playing, to keep it real, was Grux and Murdoch and Sparrow and Iggy. That I really just love playing. I don't know what it is. I just love playing these guys. They're my go-to guys as far as when I solo queue. Because when I solo queue, it's really good that you do have you have a good arsenal as far as playing different roles. For jungler, you know, I do Grux when I'm solo queuing, or when I'm lane pushing, I like playing Iggy as a caster, or when I carry, I like playing Murdoch for energy and Sparrow for physical. Sometimes, also, it's really important to keep a team comp into consideration when you are solo queuing. Because the last thing you want is not being able to be versatile, or being not able to fill a role, which is a key. It's a really big key as far as team composition. That's one of the reasons why I also picked up Sparrow in the later time of me playing Paragon. I used to just play Murdoch as energy. But then I came into a couple instances where a lot of my teams or my carries, when all the roles were taken up, the only position I had open was to play, Murdoch. as energy, and we would end up having like four energy on one team, which was really bad, where I could have picked, you know, another physical or somebody to kind of balance that out. So that's the reason I picked up Sparrow too, you know, just to have a physical carry and then Murdoch with my energy carry. I usually play Murdoch a lot more. I'm a lot more used to Murdoch than I am with Sparrow, but Sparrow is just as good with carrying. You know, she's another carry that I really like playing with. I think she has a better toolkit than Murdoch, but the thing that I like about Murdoch is his sniping. Obviously, a lot of Murdoch mains know that sometimes you have really good games where you just land all those snipes, and then you have those other bad games where you just can't land a snipe at all, and it's just frustrating. But right here, I try to get the Murdoch, but he escapes, unfortunately. So I go down. I see a team fight breaking down in the jungle. I know everybody's gonna rotate to the bigger fight, so I go and help them out. We do manage to get all of them picked off, I believe. Grux kills the other Grux, and then Rampage using his ultimate, but we still manage to kill him. It's just way too much for him. As far as Iggy in a team fight, it's hard to like do something. The only thing you can really do with Iggy when you're in a team fight is throw down crap ton of turrets, like zone out. You could zone out possible escapes that somebody could exit through, or possible entrances that somebody could enter through when the team fight is going on, or sometimes you don't have that time to or the convenience to do that, so you just throw down a bunch of turrets where people could possibly go, and different ways in which an enemy could possibly go to do a lot of damage. Especially in this build, I have pretty good amount of damage on here. I still have my my barriers though, and my physical armor, and I could have rotated over right here to help my team with Prime, but while they were doing it, that I was just, the best of luck to me was to get the mid tower while they were doing that, because I knew three of them were still up, because we ended up not killing that Rampage, I believe, so I went just to mid tower to take it. It was worth it though. I died, but we took down their tier 2 tower to expose their mid lane as well. So, but as far as the CXP was running in this game, man, I was pretty up there, man. I think I was carrying as far as CXP wise. I'm not sure, but that's what it is about older gameplays, because I don't remember every little detail. As far as live commentary, you remember everything because it's in the moment, obviously. And I'm going to do those in the beginning, later, the live commentaries, just to get used to it. But, and also, you know, because I really want to do it too. I see our Kai was really focusing a lot on our Rampage as far as when the team fights were breaking out, because that's the thing you really don't want to do. But, you know, anyways, you know, our Kai was doing amazing in this game. Same with our Grux, was doing amazing. But right here, I know there's a team fight breaking out. Richter, he eventually dies, but he gives it his all before he does die. Our Grux was doing really good, but the only thing right here where he messes up is he focuses Rampage, which is not something you would want to do. Because right here at the end, before he dies, he hits, I think, Sparrow like one time, and he takes like a big chunk out of her health. You see that? You know, the thing you want to do, man, you want to focus those carries all the time. Especially in that situation, there was a Rampage, he was a tank, and he had your two carries, your damage dealers. He had your Sparrow and your Murdoch, you know, doing damage constantly on you while you're hitting Rampage like a wet paper napkin, you know, which was the bad part. But anyways, man, we all have those moments, man. But we were doing pretty good. Right here, I was the only one up, man, I believe, and I had to protect all these towers, man. I knew that tier 2 was gone, so I was like, yo, I need to protect this inhibitor. And then I have to go to mid lane too, and protect the mid lane too. Our Murdoch goes to right lane, which is really good. He goes to right lane, but, you know, I think he gets picked off right here, man. So, ultimately, that left him, our right inhibitor, wide open. But yet again, you already know what it is. I had a portal stone over there before they took the challenge. I mean, the inhibitor. They took all my challenge though. They couldn't run into this ultimate. But I used my ultimate, man, to take out those inhibitors. Because I know if they had a chance, Rampage would just a tower dive that. Same with Sparrow. She would just run in there. I could have laid down a bunch of turrets, but I wanted to be extra safe. So I just pulled out that inhibitor. That ultimate to save the tower. Which is good. Some people, they shame it when you use your ultimate or something. Like a Gideon, he uses ultimate. Or, you know, a gadget uses their ultimate to stop a wave. But I mean, that's the best thing you could do. That was the best situation. The best option I had was to use my ultimate before they all went in there, which is good. That's completely fine, you know, because you know, at the end of the day, what it is, you have to protect your towers. You know, that's the main focus of the game, protecting towers, not so much getting kills, but protecting your towers. Right here, you know, the game, it kind of picks up again right here now, because I think another team fight breaks down to be, later, and I think that was the one that ultimately wins our game here. At this point, though, I was just trying to level up, trying to get to those 60 points, because, I did have a replacement card for Portal Stone, because I used Portal Stone in some other games, and those other games didn't go as well as planned, and I would have Portal Stone, but you wouldn't have any towers to go to or any inhibitors to go to, so you would have Portal Stone for like no reason. And so I replaced Portal Stone, if that's ever an option, with another card that gives it, I think, more mana and a little bit of health as far as for the Portal Stone. Oh no, I had a blink shot on it. Yeah, I changed it out to a blink shot, because it used to be 7 points for it, but now it's 5 points, so I just put a blink shot to replace Portal Stone, which again, you could change it up. You could replace the Portal Stone with a Mad Stone Gem, a 2 point card, and just put a minor cast or minor whatever on it, and you'll have those 5 points. But I just went for the blink shot, just, you know, just for the heck of it, to have that extra escape when I'm pushing lanes, or you know, when I'm trying to push down inhibitor or whatnot. But right here, I do pick up blue buff, and I still have a little bit of red buff. I wanted to pick up blue buff right before I went back, because I see our team is really trying to push towers again. So I get rid of my lesser health, and I put my last card, which is more major cast. So you have 190 damage so far right here, as you see. I used that card. That's my other card. But anyways, yeah, man, I really like this build. It's really good. I've used a lot of different builds on Iggy. Like, I've tried like damage, I tried crit. Like, when I do a character, I try a lot of different things. Like, I've tried crit, which is obviously not even good with Iggy, because the main thing you do with Iggy is you're always with minions. Like, that's the niche that Iggy fills. You're always around minions. So obviously I put the power cord in there to give a 10% energy damage to minions. That may not seem like a lot, but once you have that big death ball minion ball built up, trust me, it does a lot of damage, and it helps a lot. It helps, you know, not a lot, but it helps to a little degree, in which you could maybe take the tower, or maybe you don't get that sliver of health that's left here. So right here, I believe, is the final big team fight that breaks out at the late game. Right here, I notice that he's focusing Rampage again, but I ignore Rampage, and I try to go for their Murdoch, which he's trying to get away here. Like I said, I'm trying to put turrets on the exits and that little spot that they're in. They ultimately pull me back in, but it's not even a problem at this point. It's just free kills. Good time that our teammates rotated all over here. Then we see Sparrow running away, and I noticed that Grox is having a hard time killing Iggy, so I go over and help him, because I didn't know if he was going to kill him or not, but he does kill him. And again with that Kai, man, getting the orb. Yeah, so the game's, you know, pretty much done by now. I got 60 card points, that's the build, 208 energy damage, 2500 health. You have 9 points into physical armor and 9 points into your barrier. Yeah, at this point of the game, I was so confused and caught up in the T-fight. I thought that they didn't kill the orb, but he already killed the orb. Obviously, I have the freaking power-up. Stupid moment. But yeah, man, I think we just end up taking their mid inhibitor by, like, force right here. Like, I think... yeah, they just get completely melted. Sparrow's dead. But yeah, I really like this build. It has a 208 energy damage. You got your health built up, and you also got that damage, and you got your armors, so which is really good. You got the 10% with the power cord. I believe you have a pretty good pool of mana as far with Iggy. You could you do have the option to replace your health with a little bit more mana if you think you need that. Or you could do it vice versa. If you think you're not using too much mana, you could exchange it for your health. So that's a really good deal. I do notice that the left inhibitor is getting pushed. And I know our teammates wanted to take it down, but as far as like the Rampage and the Grux was like really causing a problem, so I decided just to rotate back, just to secure, just to be extra safe that the inhibitor didn't go down. And we also get the Ryan inhibitor too, which is really good as well. But the last thing I wanted was our inhibitor getting taken down, and it almost does get taken down, and I swear to God it was about to get taken down. If it wasn't for that orb power up, we would have lost this inhibitor. And also for Murdoch too, he also cycled over here to the left inhibitor. And you can see, oh my god, like I swear I thought we lost that inhibitor, man. But it barely survives. And we take down their middle inhibitor, which is really good. Really, really good. With Iggy, man, like you already know, you have to have really good map awareness as far as inhibitors and towers. You always got to be on point with that. And right here, I managed to use my last portal stone to get a kill right here. The thing about portal stone that I really don't like about it is sometimes you don't know where you're teleporting to. Because as you see, it shows that I'm teleporting over there. Luckily, they had a harvester in the enemy team, so I was able to portal stone right into the action. looking back at this, I should have not taken the kill. I was a little saucy right there. My bad, but I took the kill. But anyways... I try to put a little bit more pressure on her right side. But yeah, like I was saying, sometimes when you use Portal Stone, the other bad side besides the 300 second cooldown is the sometimes you don't know where you're teleporting to. You can kind of get a gist of where you're teleporting to, but sometimes if you have a harvester next to a tower, you may not know if you're teleporting to the harvester or the tower. In this case, when I did use Portal Stone, like in the right lane and in the beginning of the game, I did teleport to the harvester, and that's what I wanted to do because I wanted to gank them and, you know, get the kill before they even took the towers, which obviously you saw it worked out pretty good. You know, right here I pick up blue buff again just for that extra mana to finish off the game, you know, and hopefully we're just gonna rush through here in the middle, group up and attack mid. But yeah, man, it was a really good game. I hope you guys enjoyed the gameplay, man. You know, you got the old surrender, but I hope you guys enjoyed the game. I bring you guys a lot more content. You know, whatever you want to see in the comments, you know, feel free. I'll respond to you, whatever you got to, you know, say. And you already know, man, you know, I just love playing Paragon. I hope to bring you guys a lot more videos. Though, thank you, man, for checking in my first Paragon video, man. I really do appreciate it. Expect a lot more Paragon videos, those being montages, cinematics, maybe top five. We'll get started on that, but the commentaries, man, those can keep coming. But anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed, and I'll catch you guys next time. I hope you guys enjoyed the Portal Stone gameplay. Thank you guys, have a good one.